hockey is in everybody's DNA, and if you're a Canadian or live in Canada, their first sort of things they see are some wild and wonderful works of art. Piece. We had a Warhol show here a few years ago, so it's nice to have Andy back in the house. This work behind us is kind of interesting. It was a commissioned piece, and then it was rejected by the person who had asked for it to be created. And so the artist has kind of clouded up the faces a little bit here and kept it for himself. Yeah, so it's tough to bring hockey fans here and not let them take a shot or get involved. So
we have a number of different interactive things.
You can experience taking a puck in the mask at 100 kilometers an hour, in excess of 100 kilometers an hour, where you put your face up to the mask and you push the button.
It's pretty scary. It's
tough not to flinch. Then there's a deking game where you can go against the other person and you've got to roll the special ball over the lights that light up in sequence. There's one called flirting with the puck. There's a camera on each stick and on the puck, so you can see the camera or the screens of from the perspective of that. There's a great animated one with there's a static display, but then the artist created something relevant to Daryl Sittler's 10-point game.
That's pretty cool.
it's so amazing to see the effort that must have gone into it. So there's some weird and wonderful ones. I mean, but the Canada-Russia summit series, that's the memory of Canadians. It's one of those things, where were you when Kennedy was shot or Elvis died or whatever, things that matter to you. Mm-hmm. People my age and older will remember where they were. I was in like grade 11 and we skipped class. It was the eighth game, the big game. And I was in Heather Reynolds' basement because there was three prerequisites. Her parents were away. This was the middle of a school day. Her parents were away. She had the biggest television, and I think she was old enough to buy beer. And
all
so
you need, yeah.
We had about 10, my memory made it seem like hundreds, but there was probably about 10 of us there watching the game. And Canada erupted. Like, we went out in the streets and people were coming out of their homes and driving the cars like the World Cup today with flags and everything. It was just so phenomenal.
Yeah, here's a moment. Yeah.